the first match of this Men's World Floorball Championships qualification for 2022. It's Korea up against the Philippines, the first match in Group G. And here's Korea with possession now, moving it up the right flank. Max Parbren over to Rasmus Janssen, who turns and scores a magnificent goal from Rasmus Janssen, the number 65 for Korea. Gives them a deserving lead. Wonderful shot, leaving Victor Lindberg in goal with absolutely no chance. So a deserving lead here for the Koreans in this Group G clash. Our Philippines regain possession. Down to Rodel Esguera, a magnificent goal from Esguera. Beautifully set up from Matias Cortez, and Esguera with a wonderful bit of skill before unleashing a deadly swing. Magnificent stuff, and that puts the Philippines level early here in the second period. Look at what it means to him. Now the Philippines looking to capitalize on that goal, and that's exactly what they've done. A magnificent effort from Melvin Mendoza, taking advantage of what looked like a sleepy Korean defense at the back. And that's two in quick succession for the white shirts. Suddenly, from a goal down, they've now turned things around and lead 2-1. This makes for a very interesting rest of the contest. There you see Mendoza again taking advantage of that lapse, that loophole in the defensive line of the Koreans, and ultimately making no mistake. Now looking to extend their advantage, moving the ball around nicely. Varga. Oh, it's put in by Christian Castrillo. So again, defensive lapses witnessed in the Korean back line. Mendoza squares it for Christian Castrillo, who made no mistake from close quarters, and that means the Philippines are now 3-1 to the good. Korea now looking to salvage some pride, maybe pull one back. Here's Max Parbren. Max Parbren puts it in, and the Koreans give themselves a sniff of a chance heading into the final few minutes. Cool as you like, Max Parbren, definitely the standout player for the blue shirts today in this contest. And Victor Lindberg, bit of miscommunication.
Welcome to the Men's World Floorball Championship Qualifiers 2022 AOFC. This is game two of day one as New Zealand and Thailand battle it out. So Thailand looking for a way through. Here's Suksem. Suksem trying to drag that through. Goes across court, and that's a point finish. So that's the first shot of the game as we see Santhipong Suksem make it 1-0. Wasn't going to be the easiest for the New Zealand defense to keep him at bay. Looks like there might be a chance, and yes, there is. It's Thirawat Noisoy who knocks in the second goal, and Team Thailand are certainly beginning to bear their claws here. Lovely setup coming from Alexander Rinfok. Very sweet assist. It looks like, well, there may be something in the air for Team Thailand. Rinfok with the assist, and once more, it is only the lad with the execution who differs. The second assist for Rinfok, but it's Virasak Pimpa with the finish. And, well, the goals are just coming here for Team Thailand. The captain passing it to Rinfok. Rinfok will receive it back again. And the captain makes the call. Sweet assist there from the captain, and a lovely finish once again from Pimpa. So Virasak Pimpa netting his brace. Absolutely wonderful play here from Team Thailand. And right there in the second period, well, the goals keep coming. Simon Johansson's got a finish too. Lovely finish from Johansson. Sweet assist from Jira Yuth Yaimium earlier to his teammate Johansson. and he decides to step in. Didn't take him too long to net his brace. Simon Johansson back in there with another effort. So it certainly looks like, well, Team Thailand are piling those goals on. And it's finally Katsawang Wong who decides to get in. Sikusem with the assist, and that's a lovely finish there from Liam Katsawang Wong. This is day one, match number three, as Japan and Australia clash. It's Australia looking to make early inroads. Here's captain Daniel Gartner taking it through. Yes, Thomas Gartner, the other twin. It's a beautiful solo run, and what a finish! Wall had to finish what he started, and that's exactly what he's done. Thomas Gartner puts Australia ahead fairly early in the game. It's the first period itself, and lovely strike. Absolutely lovely goal here from Thomas Gartner. So 1-0, Team Australia. Keeper Takizawa certainly wasn't expecting that. Australia still not really controlling the game, but they've just got the edge over Japan and after that single goal. Oh, what a finish! What an absolutely super finish there from Tobias Knox-Little to make it 2-0. And a lovely assist coming in from Jordan Noel. Jordan Noel grabbing possession, takes it through, finds his teammate, feeds it to him, and Knox-Little with a finish. Nice finish from the number five, Ramsau Kenta, 2-1. Slight defensive slip up from Australia, which gave Japan their lead earlier. Now that's a beautiful throw by Takizawa. Here's Maria. Needs a tap in and he's got it. So Shin Nakamura makes it 2-2. And Team Japan are fighting fit here, are trying to get back into the action. It is, of course, going to be a very, very tough battle here between these sides. Game on back again at the OCBC Arena, and it was a really awesome throw from Takizawa. So Shin Nakamura restoring parity earlier for Team Japan. Now here's Gartner, there's the goal. Was denied earlier when the goal was ruled out, but this time it will stay. Daniel Gartner has finally found the target, and that's what's made the difference here, as it's now 3-2, and Team Australia certainly look like they have a sniff of victory. Daniel Gartner, now the twins both have a goal each. Here's Doyle. Well, he takes that around. Oh, lovely assist, and what a finish! Gavin Standel making it 4-2, and it looks like this game might just be beyond a comeback for Team Japan. We've just got barely a few minutes left on the clock. And Gavin Standel with the fourth goal for Team Australia. And this, of course, is the game between Singapore and Malaysia. Team Singapore looking for Ovevelli early through. Yes, Fu Junwei takes it around, slots that home, and that is the first goal, the opening for the home team, as Fu Junwei has put in the first one. It's now 1-0. A lovely effort from Junwei, who doubles up normally as a forward or a defender. Very versatile player. Lovely shot from him. Well, Malaysia looking to get back on level terms, and that is such a sweet finish. Devesh Mohan makes it 1-1. Well, that counter effort, absolutely marvelous from Team Malaysia. Lovely setup by Chong Han Kyong earlier for the Malaysians, but now it's Team Singapore who want to get back that lead that they had. Here's Ichiro Pal Singh, and he takes it through all on his own, and he's got the commanding celebration there. Absolutely love that. Ichiro Pal Singh, fabulous effort from him. And it's now 4-1. And that's another great shot. Nicholas Jua was in and around the area, and he's finally got a slice of the pie himself. That's what you really require. You require, of course, players to stand up to the occasion. Malaysia fought hard, but it's Team Singapore, well, who certainly have the lead. Oh, that's a beautiful effort. And it's Vignesh Abbasubathi finds the gap there through the keeper and the post. And these two lads, the Abbasubathi twins, what an effort from them. So Vignesh Abbasubathi giving us a beautiful goal earlier. And that's a tap-in from the debutant. It is Chan Jiaqing who makes it through with his first goal on the international stage and in his debut match. So tough times here for Team Malaysia as Singapore relentless in attack. Here is Vignesh Abbasubathi. That's a lovely backhand effort just to knock that in. But intelligent play there from Vignesh Abbasubathi, using that backhand perfectly. So that's just about 8 goals to many now. Fabian Chow knocking that through, and what a finish! Well, this is really what you call the spirit of sport. Benedict Theo, he was chasing it down for a whole period of time, but he's finally got one goal in, and it's ended here. Singapore 8, Malaysia 2.